Question 10, you have a x against t graph, okay? Except right that you see that this graph, I hope you actually see that this graph, right, is not symmetrically distributed, right, about x equals to 0, or which is to say, right, that this piston may be off, okay? There's a zero error in the calibration or something. So equilibrium position, right, is not at where the scale reaches zero. So with that, right, then you can go on and find, hence, right, what is the period. Without that, right, some people will make the mistake, or they will read perhaps, right, a convenient point here. They'll read a convenient point here. They'll see that, oh, half of a period, right, is equals to 6.4 minus 3, so which is 3.4, so period equals to 6.8, and you use this to calculate the frequency, and of course, right, this is wrong. Oh, because the points that you have selected, right, is not corresponding to where the equilibrium position is, okay? So you have to choose other points. So and this graph, right, you shouldn't spend time going and find out what is the equilibrium position, because it's time consuming to go and figure out what level is equilibrium and go and draw a new axis and so on. Simply, right, you can just read off the graph from the peak, okay, to another peak. So with this here, right, this will be one period, and you go on and use omega equals to 2 pi over t, and you calculate. Oh, and also take into account, right, the time here, right, is millisecond. So you see in the options, right, you only have two different numerical value, okay? It's 1 and the 1.6, or rather 10 and the 1.6. So if you have noticed that, right, it means that it's testing you on two things: whether, right, you calculate it correctly, and next, right, is whether you have taken note of the correct order of magnitude, okay, for the period. So answer is A.